All right, Danny.
What up? What up?
Been a long time, bro. Been a long time. Glad to see you succeeding out here, man. Like, real talk. You know
what I'm saying? Well, Mr. Hughes, glad that you still out here doing your thing, too. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we run into pitfalls, and one of those shit stop us. And you're a warrior. Man, shout out.
Appreciate that, yo. So, real talk, today you had a crazy battle.
Oh, my God. I don't know what people expect. When you got block on block crime, you get the best battles that possibly that battle rap can offer you.
Mm-hmm.
And in terms of the writing, in terms of the written material, when you got block on block crime, that's the highest level of bars you can get in battle rap today.
You think writer's block is the most talented lyricist?
Definitely. If you look at the top three battle of the year candidates, which is me, Chilla, Danger Zone, and then you have the top five, top 10 battles of the year, at least five of those battles are writer's block battles.
Right.
So what is that? What statement does that make? That means we're the most talented guys in battle rap right now. We're saving the art of lyricism.
Yeah, y'all really bringing the conversation.
We're saving the art of lyricism.
Facts, I feel you on that. Do you think you won the battle tonight?
I don't do that no more, bro. I don't. I just let the fans pick who they, you know what I'm saying? I'm too old for that now. I just go on, put on a show, and if you felt Chilla won, you felt I won, I don't even care.
I'm going to say this. I heard a couple people after the battle say that they looking at you 3-0, not a body.
Yeah.
Of course, it can't be a body, but through edging every round.
Right, yeah. Several people came and told me that I edged every round 3-0. You know what I mean? But shout out to Chilla, you know what I'm saying? He's one of the greatest pins that we ever seen, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I'm on a mission to be the goal, and I said, God bless you, man, to stand in front of these bars. Like I said, I don't call winners or losers no more. I let the people pick them.
Do you think this is one of your most classic battles ever?
Man, I got so many of them, man. Honestly, like, not even though, like, not on no, like, pat myself on the back type of thing, but I mean, after me and Danger, me and Chilla, me and Breaks Belvedere, me and KG the Poet, me and Ron Nitty, me and Mr. Mills, oh my God, I literally have the most classics. Bar Fest, at least, out of any battle in history. And that's a fact. That's not a pin.
What more do you think that you need to do in order to be considered the GOAT?
Well, I told in the trailer, I said in order to be a legend, you got to beat legends.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? I beat Rex. You know what I'm saying? I went war with A-Ver. A lot of people thought I won or lost. A lot of people got it half and half. I'm in there with the legends and beating these niggas. You know what I'm saying? So what's next for me is maybe a showdown with Loaded Lux. You know what I'm saying? That's the only thing I, you know, really want right now. Me and Daylight is up next, and he's like my personal favorite battler.
Mm-hmm.
But me and Daylight are gonna give him another classic. After that, maybe me and Jonai, up and coming crazy pin game guy. And I want Tay Rock on either Gnome 6 or Summer Madness 6. Me and Tay Rock gonna go in there and be super aggressive and cuss at each other.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I probably want to end my career off with, you know, beating Loaded Lux. Straight up.
Yeah, okay. Who do you think out of that list is the most difficult to defeat?
Daylight's the most difficult to defeat out of like every battler in the world.
Why you say that?
When he rapping, like not the antique, not the gimmick thing, but when he does the writing, his mind really works on another level. And his penmanship, the way he has his intricate patterns, he's a great writer, straight up. And to me, he's the best. I don't want to get like too much high praise and seem like I'm a big writer or nothing like that, but just coming from a writer, I understand what it takes that goes into what he does. You know what I'm saying? I don't think nobody else can do what he does.
You've heard a lot of T-Rex bars recently, a lot of opponents. Do you think that Chilla Jones' angle is the most effective one?
Well, I rebuttal it, first off. Secondly, I think it was very fair. I think it was done the smartest.
Okay.
I think it was done very, that was very well executed what Chilla did with the 12K angle and the kid went to my kids and a year of groceries. Like, all that shit was some real shit, you know what I'm saying? So, I respect Chilla for that. But sometimes when you hear the same angle, it don't affect me. I hear this every time. Like, I keep getting the same angles. Oh, Danny, you're old. Oh, Danny, Vicky, this. They always bring my wife into it. Or they bring up the 12K. Like, none of those things affect me because I've heard them already. So it doesn't matter. Even if you've done it better than the next guy, it don't hurt me.
Now that you've gotten the Rex battle out of the way,
yeah,
you can reflect on your decision to give him the 12K. Do you regret it?
Nah. He can't live with regrets, man. I mean, in hindsight, you know what I'm saying? I felt like he definitely was overpaid because he didn't give me a 12K performance.
Right.
See, at the time when I gave him the money, he was like hot on the Total Slaughter show. You know, he was a champ and he had Charlie Clips coming up. This was prior to the Clips battle when I gave him the money. So Rex was that nigga at the time, you know what I'm saying? But when I gave him the money, I don't know, I think he maybe that money kind of hurt him. Honestly, like, it might have made him lose a bit of hunger for this. Like, I don't know. Because he ain't been the same.
One thing I want to ask is, do you think that Rex has either lost the hunger, or do you think that, in all honesty, Rex has failed to evolve with the culture?
Exactly, that's what it is.
You think
I've been saying that.
Been stuck in the past?
I've been saying that. I've been saying that about him 15 years ago. And that's why I said, when I battle him, I'm going to do that. I'm going to expose that he hasn't evolved. See, what I tell people is Rex is the iPhone 1. At the time, he was the highest, you know, he was the shit. But then you fast forward, now we're on iPhone 6, about to be on iPhone 7. He's still iPhone 1. So he never, his technology with the right never evolved. So now when you get guys like me and Clips and Danger Zone in front of him, you put us in front of him, he's gonna die horribly every time because he didn't evolve. Like Lux, the thing that kind of saves Lux is Lux was already ahead of his time, so we're just now kind of catching up to him. And I think a few of us have passed Lux pin wise, definitely.
Okay, well, something we spoke about off camera, man, and you mentioned it jokingly just now, the age joke.
Yeah. A lot of people bring up the age thing that, oh, Danny's 35, he's 40 years old. But realistically, this isn't like football, basketball, where age affects your body. I think in terms of being a writer, age helps you with the mind. This is a mental thing. This rap thing is a mental thing. So when you get guys like Clint Eastwood still writing movies, that's from that's age and experience. This guy's what, 76 years old? So, you know what I mean? Honestly, I could do this shit forever if I wanted to.
Yeah, when people want to try to, you know, throw shade, like, oh, you're 30, whatever,
right,
years old, it's like,
it doesn't affect me.
For me, you look at Jay-Z, look at
Nas. Eminem.
Buster Rhymes, Snoop. People that's still hot today.
All these guys.
And it's like, at the end of the day, like you said, it's a mental game. And people acting like, you know what's funny? They're saying it now, maybe they're 27, 28. When they hit whatever age, they're going to still be wanting to do this because it pays them.
That's what I'm trying to, like, y'all trying to clown me for being older.
Yeah.
But y'all going to get this age one day, too.
And they still going to want to do it.
It is a blessing to even be this old, because a lot of people was dead at this age, before this age. So,
that's a fact.
That don't hurt me when you say, oh, Danny, you're 35, 36. I told him. I said, these young niggas can't rap with me, because I'm about to be 36 old. That's the key.
Mm-hmm.
That's some real shit. Like, I'm too old for y'all young niggas. Y'all, if you're not 30 and up, then don't get in that ring with me, because I got too many references. I got too much life experience to lose to a nigga that's younger than me. So that's why I don't lose.